Hello folks. Well, you've caught me just coming down to the lockup, and I have a very soft front tire. Fortunately, at least I hope it's fortunately, I have what appears to be the remedy in this little box here. I received an email from Mr. Staggers, who organises the Liverpoolitan Tweedites, informing members that Lidl had these foot pumps in for £4.99. And the reason he told me that, or told us that, was because on the last Tweed run, one of the participants had a puncture, and Mr. Staggers had in his bag one of these pumps, or rather the predecessor of this pump, which was a marvellous little thing, and he said it had cost a few pounds from Lidl, and Lidl had just got them back in. So I went down there, and for £4.99 I purchased this. So now we are going to, as Derek from Vice Grip Garage says, we're going to test on it. Now, I could have done one of the traditional YouTube unboxing videos, but really, with one hand holding the phone and freezing cold, that wasn't going to happen. So here's what we get. The box says, with mini foot pump with flip down base and a universal dual pump head. And it's for American Woods and Presta valves, in other words, Schrader, the car valve, on the right there. In the middle, the Woods or Dutch valve, and which is old British bikes as well, and then the Schrader, the high pressure racing bike, road bike type valve. So it's a universal dual pump head. I think they mean, because it's a dual, it's a two-sized head, and if it's the three, universal dual isn't necessarily an oxymoron in this case. So, I've seen these heads before. I'm not convinced they do Woods. I've brought an adapter with me, because to do Woods, usually you need one of these, which is a little brass screw-on adapter that screws onto the small Woods valve and offers an outside thread, the same as a Schrader valve. And that's what you usually use. So it'll be interesting to see if it pumps a Woods without the adapter. That'll be an absolute godsend if it does, because I'm always losing these little adapters. And there's a little box on the front where I could actually keep one. It's got a toy inflator for airbeds and footballs and things in there already. So I could put my little adapter in there and carry it around. Clips off, there we are. Now, some quite a hefty little instruction booklet, mostly because it's in lots of different languages. This is what you need, really. The diagram showing that the wire that holds down the plunger acts as a footrest as well. And just clear instructions of how to use it. You don't need me to repeat what's in front of you. There's the dual head, just showing that the toy inflators and the Schrader go in the large hole, and the Woods and Presta go in the small hole. If you use a bicycle pump with a dual head, you'll know that anyway. But it's nice that they're there, and here's how it shows you operating a Woods valve. Not convinced myself, as I say. I'll be absolutely delighted if it does. I don't think I've got a Woods valve handy in this lot that I can test, so I might have to do that separately. Back at the Velocipedium, back at my little cave that I call a workshop. So here's the pump, all out, ready to use, a dual head, lovely big gauge. I do like a nice big gauge. I prefer, when I'm using track pumps, I prefer the ones with the gauges up high like this, so I can see them. But that's, and it goes up to 140 or 10 bar. Now, let's get back to this matter of the soft tyre. Give me a moment while I use both hands and we'll see what it does. Okay, I've done a couple of things and the sun's come out in the meantime, which is nice. I had to put you down to attach the pump onto the valve, but I also let the tyre right down so we can have a full inflation from completely flat. I run this tyre at about 40 psi. It's a town bike, it's quite a decent air chamber on the tyre, no need for it to be any more than that, especially being a town bike. See, I sit quite upright, my weight's to the back. The rear tyre I run about 60, this one I run about 40. So, let's give this thing a go, shall we? Try this foot first. I'm left-handed, left-footed, but I'm going to try my right foot first. Interesting noise. Sounds like me after I've ridden up a hill. That's 20 strokes. That's 40 strokes and it's nearly up to 40. Strokes from nothing to 3 bar. Not bad at all. I'll still be sat there on about 15 psi with a mini pump. Now, something I noticed when I clamped this on was that the lever, I'll do this, the lever is quite stiff to get over the detent there. I wonder if that's so that it can grip onto woods valves, or maybe it's just a bit of future proofing, because when they wear that gets slacker and slacker and then it just goes floppy, so it's got a little bit further to go. Maybe so. That's it on Presta. Let's see how it'll do on Shredder. Now, once again, it was a very positive click to get that on there, and it's gripped very well. This tyre is a 700C 622 by 37, I think this is. So it's quite a big air chamber, this. Equivalent to probably a mountain bike or something. Bunch of keys there, that's what I used to let the tyre down. The tyre was actually up, I've let it down especially for you. Right, I'm going to try the opposite foot this time. Which is counterintuitive to me. I'm just leaning slightly on the bike as well. Right. So. And I see it likes just that slight pause between strokes. It doesn't like just bang, 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 bang. It seems to work more efficiently like this. There we are, that's inflated. That's fewer strokes on this one. Maybe because I let it down, it probably wasn't flat like the other one. So again, a very quick, efficient, no leak inflation. And that came off a bit cleaner than it did off the Presta. To be fair, the bit of air I let out on that first tyre was probably because of my ham-fistedness while holding the camera. So, very good so far. Let's see how it does on woods. Now, before I leave, I thought the test wouldn't really be comprehensive unless I tried it on a road bike tyre, a high pressure tyre. This is something ridiculous, like a 21. That's a 23, I see it there. There we are, that's what it is. So let's have a go. I'm going to take it up to 100 and see how many strokes it takes. It'd be interesting to see the rate of climb of the pressure gauge compared to in a wider tyre. Right, here we go. try the other foot. Maybe I've discovered a fault. That's 5 bar. PSI. So these short barreled, wide barreled pumps usually are good for volume, not very good for high pressure. So it was a good idea to give it a test on this kind of thing. And there we are. Didn't take long at all. So that's one more type of tyre. I don't use this type of tyre very much, so it didn't occur to me to test it. Glad I remembered before I went back. Right, now back to base and do that ultimate woods test. And so the beauty with this thing is its compactness. That'll carry around in a saddlebag or a pannier or a front basket or whatever. Quite reasonably. It's maybe not something you would carry around all the time like you would a mini pump. But if you're touring, why not? Right, so there I've just popped it into one of these New Lux Mondi panniers. Should do a review on those really. I've had these a few years now, but they still make them. And they're absolutely marvellous panniers. I will do a review. There's their matching saddlebag as well. So it won't go in there like a mini pump would, but to be honest, I hate mini pumps. Now the test is to take it back to base now and try it on a woods valve and see if it'll fit without an adapter. Speaking of which, that's how I always lose these blighters. That will now go in the pocket, it will now go through the washing machine and I'll lose it again. Right, see you back at base. Right, here's part two, the woods valve. I found the old green Union, a woods valve bike, and look what I've done. I do this on, there's another one behind it, look, that's the hopper behind it, and this one. This is what I do, I carry one of these adapters on every woods valve bike, so that I can use a shredder pump. But that rather defeats the test here. I'm now going to see if this Aldi pump will go on. I mean, it's German, it's for the German market, and there are a lot of woods valves on German bikes, they've always used them. Let us see, let's waffle, less waffle, more action. I might have to put you down for a second. Right, well, so far it's gone onto the top, it's got a grip. This is where the usual, the normal type of pumps, let themselves down. They don't grip the top of the valve very well and they just flop back off. Maybe that explains why this was a bit difficult to push up before. Maybe it's because it's pushing the rubber insert, there's a little rubber insert inside, maybe it's squeezing it that little bit further to hold it onto a woods. Anyway, the tyre is completely flat. This is an original 1960s tyre, this one. So let's see, shall we? I'm going to try it the other way around, the way that was unsuccessful before. It's not coming out of the side of the valve, it seems to be going into the tyre. We have pressure, we have creaking as the bike lifts itself up an inch or so. This is a 26 by 1 3/8, 590, the British size, and it's actually in the Gazelle wheel, but it's the original tyre from the Union. And we are now on 3 bar, 45 psi, nice and hard. Wow! Wow! A modern pump. Foot pump, no less, that works on woods valves. How pleased am I? Now, Oh, that's good. I was worried that was leaking. I'm now going to put this back on because I won't always be somewhere where there's such a marvellous little pump. Valve cap back on. How's the hopper? Oh, the hopper's hard already. So, an unbelievable amount of success. All of the valve types, all of the pressure. Now this is improved over the previous models, as Staggers pointed out to me. This now has a steel body, his was plastic, and this pressure gauge is bigger than his. Now you can put that down either way, I see. Clip that over the top of there, I didn't show you this before. There we are. Fold that in. And you could now sling that into a little bag, like my little barber. It'll fit in my barber bag there, made out of a pocket of an old barber jacket. Or any pouchy type thing. I'm going to keep it in the box for a while, yeah. I know, one-handed. I wouldn't stuff it in there like that normally. And there it is in comparison to a Caradise saddlebag. Easily go in there, no problem. A Gilbert II traditional randonneur bike, that bag. Not much room for your sarnies, but it's just to demonstrate the size of the thing, really. Even in its box, very compact. Very pleased. Absolutely astounded by the quality now, and the capability. Oh, that's good. I was worried that was leaking. I'm now going to put this back on because I won't always be somewhere where there's such a marvellous little pump. Valve cap back on. How's the hopper? Oh, the hopper's hard already. So, an unbelievable amount of success. All of the valve types, all of the pressure. Now this is improved over the previous models, as Staggers pointed out to me. This now has a steel body, his was plastic, and this pressure gauge is bigger than his. Now you can put that down either way, I see. Clip that over the top of there, I didn't show you this before. There we are. Fold that in. And you could now sling that into a little bag, like my little barber. It'll fit in my barber bag there, made out of a pocket of an old barber jacket. Or any pouchy type thing. I'm going to keep it in the box for a while, yeah. I know, one-handed. I wouldn't stuff it in there like that normally. And there it is in comparison to a Caradise saddlebag. Easily go in there, no problem. A Gilbert II traditional randonneur bike, that bag. Not much room for your sarnies, but it's just to demonstrate the size of the thing, really. Even in its box, very compact. Very pleased. Absolutely astounded by the quality and the capability. Thank you, Aldi. Thank you, Hildebrand Staggers. And a shout out to the Liverpoolitan Tweed Ride, and there are a couple coming up shortly. Google the term Liverpoolitan Tweed Ride if you want to come and join us. Thank you for watching.